Hi, I'm Sanjay Nagchowdhury, Development Lead for the IBM App Connect Enterprise product. In this video, I will demonstrate a new capability in version 12 to create a JUnit test for a message flow node using the toolkit. After creating the test case, I will run the test case to show the results in the JUnit view. So in this message flow, I have a compute node, which is transforming an XML message into a JSON message. If I send an XML message to the flow, I click send. So here's an XML message. You can see that it has been transformed to a JSON message. So what I want to do is to create a test case for this compute node. And if I create a test case for this compute node, then I can add it to my pipeline so I can ensure that any future changes to this compute node will not regress the capability in this flow. So what I can do is select the compute node. I can right click on it and select create test case. A wizard is shown, which shows some options on the left-hand side and a preview of the test case on the right-hand side. So changing the options on the left-hand side will affect the test case that is generated. For example, I can select before all and after all, and you can see that the methods have been added to the test case. So for this test case, I want to confirm the logic in the compute node is correctly transforming an XML message to a JSON message. I have an input XML file, which I can select. It's inside my application. So I'm going to select this XML file as the input file, and I am going to select a example JSON file, which will be used as the expected message to compare against. And here you can see that the because I've selected the input file and the output file, the test case has been created accordingly, and we'll go into the details of that code after it's been generated. So at this point, I can just click finish. And the test case will be created inside a test project. So a test project is a new first class artifact that is new in version 12 of App Connect Enterprise. It's used to contain test classes and resources that are used by those classes. The test project is structured in a format that can be used with Gradle or Maven. And when creating that test project through the wizard I just used, you can actually change the test project name if you want to. You can also independently create the test project and create the test case in it. So I can see that the test project has been created. It has a name of the application name underscore test. If I look at the properties of this of the project, of the test project, I can see it has a reference to the application that's under test. The test case itself that's been generated has the it's been created in a package called test. It has the necessary imports that are required. And it is using an input message assembly that is sent to the input terminal of a compute node, and an output message assembly is taken from the output terminal of a compute node. A message body is extracted from the output message assembly tree, and an assertion is made to say that the actual message body that's received matches the expected message body. I'm going to go into details about the different classes that are used in a separate video. For now, I'm just going to take you through an overview of creating the test case and running it. So the assertion here will be true if it matches, and so then the test case will pass, and if it doesn't match, the test case will fail. There are a couple of other assertions in this test case as well, which assert that how many times the node is called, so it's been called once, and which output terminal the message is being propagated to. So I can run this test by simply selecting the test project, right-clicking on it, and selecting Run Test Project. That will actually start an integration server, and it will start it with some special options, and you can see that the test has been run and it has passed. Now, the options that were used to start that integration server can be changed using the Run Configuration wizard. So to show the power of creating a unit test and adding it to a pipeline, let's see what happens if I had actually changed, if a flow developer had made a change to the compute node code, which has caused a regression in the capability. So for example, let's change demo to person here and save it. So now if I run test again, we will see that the test has failed. Okay, and if I select this button here, which says show stack trace in console view, I can see that it's saying that expected demo but person was used. So if I change this back to demo and save and rerun the test, we can now see that the test has passed. So in this video, I've given an introduction to the new capability in App Connect Enterprise version 12. You can now create a unit test for individual message flow nodes and subflows. The tests can be then added to your pipeline so that you can be sure of not regressing your integration solutions before they're deployed. I'm going to go into the details of the test classes that are used in the test case in a separate video. I mentioned something called message assembly. I will describe what a message assembly is in another video as well and show other ways of creating a test case.